Okay.
I'm in Gansu, in northwest China, on the edge of the Gobi Desert, and the reason I want to spend some time here alone is because this is a really fascinating place, historically. As a martial artist, I'm interested in a particular style of stick fighting that came from these parts, Kurdzugun. The guys didn't have metal weapons, they didn't have guns, they didn't have swords, they just had a stick, and their job was to protect the wealthy traders as they brought their silk and their spices into central China. You know, I'm hoping to be able to find a bit of inspiration for myself, really, by spending some time here. Jumped in the river, what did I see? Martial arts are not only taught in villages. In China, some of the most stunning performances can be found in universities. I'm here to meet Master Li. He started his wushu career in 72, and by 83 he was a coach. He's led his teams to over 70 national victories, and students travel the length and breadth of China to come here, Lanzhou University, just to train with him. Li Lao Shi,
ni hao. Ni hao, ni hao, ni
Martial arts is not just about performance and flying spears. Here in the mountains of North China and at 9,000 feet altitude, this military breeding ground has been turning wild horses into war horses for over 2,000 years.
These horses are wild, they're being broken in, so I expect it to give me a bit of a hard time, but let's see what he's got. Okay, clear off. Ha, shushaba.
Survived another night alone. Pay no mind, I'm doing fine. I'm breathing on my own. I'm here.
They're military horses. They're designed to be strong and a little bit aggressive. You know, they're designed to go straight into battle, so they have to be a little bit feisty and brave. But I think, as you could see, breaking them in is a very, very dangerous process because they're not happy about it. They're wild animals and they want to be wild.
Wake me when the hour arrives. Wake me with my name. See you somewhere down the line. We're tethered once again.
Weather can change dramatically quite quickly. That's exactly what it's done. I don't know if you can see, but it's snowing now. So we had to stop out on the plains there. And the boys said to me, there's one thing they do, a bit of a tradition here when the weather changes like this, because they can't do anything out there. And that is have a drink. They've invited me to join them. And I think that's exactly what I'll go and do.
Oh, shit. Qingke alcohol, and as you can see from the colour, it's basically a pure spirit. I've got to drink two of these first, as I'm the guest of honour today, so cheers. Oh! Ah! Oh!
Traditional 武术呢，在这个解放初期的时候，那些武馆什么的已经完全都取消了。对，70岁的人，你看，你敢吗？过来打你。 打死你，就是70岁。我们练的这个传统武术，就是原来北京的第三国术馆，但是那会儿我说了，练武术的就穷文，啊，富武，所以在成分都不好，所以你看我们这个第三国术馆现在，就是我是一个唯一的一个传承人。
This is Bagua. It's a style that's very popular in Beijing. And this guy is 70 years old. These are his two students. He's been teaching for most of his life. And he loves to fight.
这叫单手擒拿，是一个手。我那么多的师叔，师大爷，但是都因为他们成分不好。 啊，也不能去传授，但是他们年龄现在的活着都是100多，已经都死了，所以呢，只是我唯一的一个人了，我也很有时候很着急，也愿意把这个真正的传统武术去传承下去，但是找一个好的徒弟很难，确实很难。
Back in the capital, Beijing, in the car park under the Bank of China, lives a group of extraordinary men, masters of Iron Fist.
I had a Subway sandwich earlier and I went for the 6-inch one and it's about the same size as his hand.
Protecting the artifacts of Kung Fu is a common theme amongst masters, but the stories of the personal sacrifices required to do that usually go untold.
I know this little park in Beijing really well. I went to university 20 years ago just around the corner. But it wasn't until a couple of years ago when I was researching my book, I came across a really interesting fella. His name is Grandmaster Li, and the art he practices is Saw Gu Gong.
杰是一个朋友，家以前前辈呢是保镖的，保镖以后后人以后就没有人再练了，在家里放着，卖人家不卖，花钱买是不卖，他想找个传人，一起分享这个这份兵刃，但是我没办法，我就总上家里去，最后实在没办法，就是我太因为太喜欢这种兵器了。 后来呢，又有一只翡翠的镯子，是我的老师送我的老伴儿了。我用这镯子换了所有的兵器，所以我这东西比我的命还重要，我就特别珍惜它，因为晚年我就陪伴我一起。 一起健身，一起练武，在中华武术里，我把这个好的兵刃给保存下来，将来留给后人，传给将来有机会的话传给后人，这是我最大的想法。There
is a huge nobility to sacrificing material goods for your art, despite their abject poverty, despite the hardships that they've suffered, and the, you know, just the difficult times and the difficult conditions that they live in. There is a certain contentment. The skills that they have, the viewpoint that they've developed has allowed them to rise above, to a degree, above their own circumstances, and I think that is valuable.